Hello and welcome back to Tales of Lumen. Today we're going to be unboxing the Overwatch Recruit Kit. I realize I'm a little bit late cracking this baby open. I know, like, a lot of people received these before the game even released, but mine arrived just a couple of days after we arrived here at the new place, so I haven't really had time to open it and record a video, but I'm doing that now. It's cool. Don't even worry. We're going to have a look inside there. It's probably going to be very exciting stuff. I have no doubt. Along with that, however, we're going to speak briefly about Overwatch competitive play. It's now live in all regions, and I'm going to be jumping in there for my first couple of games, the placement games, later this evening. I'm a little terrified, actually, but before we talk about that, recruit kit. Let's crack this baby open. Let's go. I have seen a couple of photos and stuff of what's inside here, so I'm not going in completely blind, but you know, it's not the same as actually having it in your hand, seeing it all up close. Now let's start with the papers and stuff. It opens much the same as all the Blizzard Collector's Editions and stuff do. See, the two pieces. I'm very bad at this, at holding things in the right places. First up, we have stickers. These are really cool. You know, I like stickers and all, but at the same time, I really dislike stickers. I actually hate them because I never want to stick them anywhere. Because once you do, that's it. They're stuck. You can't take them off and put them somewhere else. Okay, maybe you can if you stick them on like a special surface or something. But I'm a collector and I like things being in pristine condition. So I always feel bad about sticking stickers. Here. Yeah. And like opening figurines and stuff like that. But these are cool. These are, if I'm not mistaken, some of them at least are the cute sprays in game. Like that's cute 76. That's definitely not cute Winston. I don't know what that is. It says, don't get me angry. There's the Tracer one that says, cheers love. There's the Overwatch logo. That's cute McCree. Again, if I'm not mistaken. This one, it actually says, power up there. I know that because I have that spray in-game. This one is Here Little Piggy for Roadhog, and again, another Overwatch logo. The logos are different colors. The one's white, the one's gray. You can't actually see the white one very well, but whatever, it's there. I promise to you, it's there. Next up. This was really interesting to me. I didn't expect it. This is Lucio music, and funny enough, it's not on a CD or a DVD as you'd expect. It's on a vinyl? That's weird. And you know, I went into a music shop here recently for whatever reason. We were like hanging out in a mall and I saw an entire shelf full of vinyls. It seems like it's making a comeback or something, and I'm assuming it's not just here in South Africa, maybe in other countries as well. I have been told, I actually went out and looked before starting the video, that this is Lucio music. This is like the music that he plays when he's switching up his stances or modes in-game from healing to speed. And then there's a whole lot more on here as well, but it's all from Lucio, the artist. Pretty cool. I'm sure you can download it somewhere or listen to it on YouTube or something. Unfortunately, I don't have anything to play this, so I'm not going to be able to play it for you. It does, however, look really, really cool. I like it. I like the Frog Lucio theme as well. Those skins, those legendary skins, are super cool. We move together as one. That's it. Next up. A booklet. This is the Overwatch Recruit Kit booklet. The world needs more heroes. Are you with us? It says that on the back. I'm not even sure what's in here. We're gonna look. Oh, and this is the same as the Collector's Editions box, where the print on here is like embossed or something. It's very nice that they got these multi-textured images and stuff. Ah, there's that same thing again. Look, with all the little silhouettes of the heroes. I like that. This is quality stuff. Welcome to Overwatch. This is an overview of Overwatch. I don't expect you guys to be able to read anything here. I'm just going through it quickly. It tells you here how to play your role. Really cool artwork. I think that's Numbani over there. Really, really, really cool. And it's printed on like super thick pages. Choose your hero. It's got the heroes there. These are obviously all the heroes that are currently in the game. There will be more in the future. And then there's like a full stat list. It gives you like their attacks, their health. It actually tells you about them, their full names, their age, all that stuff. Hanzo Shimada, I knew that. I did not know, however, Junkrat's name was Jamison Forks. Jesse McCree, I did know that one. Mercy's Angela Ziegler. Very cool. A lot of unknowns in here, however, with like Reaper and 76. Although, we kinda know who he was before he became Reaper. Anyway. Lena Oxton, that's Tracer. So they've got all the details of the heroes and stuff here, it's very cool. Then, it tells you about the objectives, the types of maps that you'll be playing on. Again, the artwork's amazing. Nice thick pages, super glossy here. Showing off some of the maps. Damn, that's cool. Ooh, Dorado. I love and I hate Dorado because when I play on Dorado, I spend too much time looking at Dorado. You should actually, if you play Overwatch yourself, you should actually sometimes at some point take a moment and just look at the scenery, specifically the background of a lot of the maps, because you miss a lot of stuff there. Like in Dorado, have you guys seen that big pyramid of light? That's damn cool. In Ilios, have you looked down the side to see the beaches and that big like soldier statue thing and the boats and stuff and the harbor? It's nice. Oh, in Volskaya, the big robots, the mechs walking around. You should check it out. If you haven't already, you should check it out. Then at the back here, it tells you about the different editions that you can buy. So you can clearly see, and it tells you what you get in-game. This was meant to be unboxed and opened before Overwatch even came out. So again, I am super late to the party here. But that's a cool book with all the information in. Now, on to the two items that came along with this. There's a little tin with the Overwatch symbol on it. You can see that right there. It's about yay big. Quite fancy. And inside is a pin of the Overwatch logo. If I ever go to like an event or something where I got a dress all formal like, I put my suit on, I will pin this to my chest. It's right behind the, there you go, to my chest, right there. I'd do that. Even if people don't know what Overwatch is, I'd wear that because it's a cool symbol. It looks nice. I like it. Okay, so it's not very big. On the back here it says Overwatch. Then it says Blizzard Entertainment 2015. Very nice. It's solid. Very, very solid. And it comes in a nice little padded tin. I don't know if there's maybe something underneath. Maybe there's something hidden in here. Like a gem of some sort. Okay, I'm not going to take it out. This doesn't want to come out. Don't want to cooperate. It's fine. I'm putting it back in. But maybe there's something hidden down there. I don't know. I'm sure someone else checked. And then the final item in this box is a coin. I'm going to open it in just a moment. I'm just going to show you what it looks like inside its container. It's like in an old school CD case or something. I haven't seen anything like this in a long time. And this one was difficult to open. There we go. Okay. It's open. Super soft here. Again, nicely padded and stuff. A little spot for you to stick your finger in. Because they know you're going to struggle getting that out. This says Omnic Crisis in Memory. Overwatch. Very, very nice. I'm going to shift the focus on my webcam quickly. If I can get my mouse over there. Because I put all this stuff on my mouse. Auto focus on. So we can zoom on that. So that we can zoom on that, please. There we go. Very cool. On the back, Blizzard Entertainment. It doesn't really need to focus on that. You know what that logo looks like, don't you? I like it. I like it a lot. I think that this was actually given to a whole lot of people when they bought their collector's editions. I don't know, the place we bought the collector's edition from initially said they were going to give us these, but they never gave us these. They ended up giving people some, like, plaques or something. I don't know what it was. It was like a metal Overwatch thing. I don't even know what art was on there because they didn't want to show it to me. It was exclusive. I don't know. Whatever. But that's the recruit kit. Lots of cool stuff in there. I'm a big fan of things like this, obviously. I'm going to find a nice spot for all these goodies somewhere on the shelf. I don't know yet exactly. It was just lying over here before, but maybe I'll display it more prominently. Now, with that out of the way, we're going to have a few quick words about Overwatch competitive mode. I'm going to open it up here in front of me. It's live. It's up on all regions. It's pretty easy to jump into competitive mode. You can just click on play and then competitive instead of quick play. We've been playing in quick play up until this point, or in practice versus AI or whatever, but competitive is the new one. And I'm assuming that if you go in there, you're going to want to be serious about winning. That's pretty important. Okay, you're going to want to go in there with the right kind of attitude. You're going to go in there expecting to work with your teammates, not play a completely solo game or whatever. And you're going to have to try. Okay? Not just mess around, because obviously your teammates won't be happy if you're messing around while they're trying to win. So don't go in there and then, like, expect to learn a new hero while playing competitive. I assume that you should go in there again, like, just knowing one or two heroes from each role, playing the heroes you know, playing as well as you possibly can. But it's up now, and we've been told that the seasons will coincide with the real seasons in the Northern Hemisphere, so this will be the summer season. It's summer now, right? It's winter with us, so it's summer there, and it'll be like 2.5 to 3 months per season. I think it's about 2.5. This first season is going to be just a little bit shorter, because it started a little late, but that's the gist of it. And then for playing in these, you get a reward once you complete your placement matches. So it works the same as Heroes of the Storm. You just need to play your 10 placement matches, and then you'll receive a spray and player icon for this season. The first season, which is the summer season of 2016, is Ilios. So you get an Ilios player icon, Ilios spray, and I think you also get currency, which is called something. I'll tell you in just a moment what it is. You use it to purchase golden weapons. Currently, you use it to purchase golden weapons exclusively. I'm assuming going forward, there'll be more stuff to buy. It's called competitive points. So based on where you finish, at what skill rating you finish at the end of the season, you'll get either more or less competitive points. It's pretty cool. And the gold weapons that you can potentially get are pretty cool for some of the characters in the game. For others, they just look a little bit ridiculous. I mean, that's a fact. You can say what you want, but like, those guns look a little silly on, like, for instance, the basic D.Va skin or whatever. Just putting golden guns on there, or like on the basic Bastion skin. I don't know. But on other characters, it looks amazing. I'm a big fan of it. I don't think you'll have enough, or I don't think most people will have enough to buy a weapon right after the first season. Maybe you'll have to only do that after the second season. I'm not entirely sure about that yet, but there are some cool rewards to get. For now, I think that's it. However, like, there's only the weapons that you can earn the points for. There will probably at some point in the future be more stuff. Don't know if it'll be maybe sprays or emotes or other cosmetic goodies that you can get, because it is all cosmetic. You get this golden weapon, you get it to show off that you're pretty good at the game, that you've played competitive mode. Sure, everyone will eventually be able to get them no matter how good or bad they are if they play competitive, but it's still somewhat of a status symbol, especially if you have multiple golden weapons on multiple characters and stuff like that. Now, when actually playing in competitive mode, things are going to be a little bit different. I will have more videos up going into more detail in the future, but I'll give you a quick rundown of how it's going to work anyway, just right now in case you were wondering. Again, I mentioned that there was a skill rating. That's what you aim in for. It's from, I think, 0 to 100. So you really good if you had 100, and then you can actually bust up into like the top X amount of players, sort of like legend rank or whatever after that. But I think you're going to want to aim for the higher numbers rather than the lower ones. And after you complete those placement matches, you'll be put somewhere probably in the vicinity of 50. A little bit higher, a little bit lower. That's probably how it's going to be for most people. Then you can grind your way up. But when you get on the map, when you're actually playing, then you will be playing a little differently than it is currently in Quick Match. For the control point maps, that's like Ilios or Lijiang Tower or whatever, you actually play in a best of 5 instead of a best of 3. So you need to win 3 rounds to be able to win the match that you're currently in. There's also a sudden death mode that's going away after the first season because it's terrible. I've just heard bad things about it. I saw it in action a couple of times, didn't look really good, but Blizzard are working on it, so I'm assuming at some point there'll be a different system that's actually better than that. So if you do somehow end of the tie, I don't think you can do that on control point maps, but on the hybrid and the payload maps, you kind of can. I don't know. Don't know exactly how that works. But on the hybrid maps and the payload maps, you play one round as the attacker, one round as the defender, and then you get a certain amount of points from those. So for like every checkpoint that you take or whatever, you get a point. And then when you actually win, when you push the payload to the end, you get a few extra points. And then they tally up the points at the end. If you're tied with the enemy team, it goes into sudden death. Play again, which, again, a lot of people have been complaining about. And then you see who the winner is. But it can take a little bit longer. I have heard of people on the control point maps taking really, really long, like upwards of 40 minutes for just one match, which is obviously best of 5, but it could be overtime going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth the whole time. That's Overwatch. You need time. If you're going into competitive, you need time. Then there are lots of penalties for leaving, for abandoning matches, and I suppose getting voted down or reported or whatever. You can get up to 75% reduced experience. You can get temporarily banned from playing competitive, and you can actually get banned for an entirety of a season. So you could potentially, if you're an idiot to people, if you keep quitting games, stuff like that, you keep getting reported, then you could just be banned from the summer season of Overwatch. That would suck. So be nice. Play as a team. Play the game like you mean it. That's it. I'm done. I have been playing quite a bit of Overwatch recently. I'm currently level 70-something, I think. Okay, that's not a lot of Overwatch. Most of the people on my friends list, most of the people I play with are well over 100. A couple of them are nearing 200 already. So compared to some people out there, I have not played that much, but I've played a decent amount. I've been playing most on Hanzo, but I've also split my time between other characters. My main favorites are Hanzo, D.Va, and Pharah. I've been playing a little bit on 76 recently. He's also pretty fun. I mean, I love Torbjorn. A good Torbjorn play on defense is cool. I have a lot to say about the characters in the game, likes and dislikes and so on and so forth, but I do have a good balanced roster and a decent amount of knowledge at least going into competitive play, so I think that'll help out. But I've been enjoying it. Overwatch has been great since its launch. I haven't been putting very many videos up since the game came out, again, mainly because we've moved and stuff like that, but I will have videos up going forward, and once I can stream, obviously, gonna be playing a lot of Overwatch, hopefully with you guys as well, or against you guys. We have some people that play with us that like to play against us. They join the games as the antagonist, and they try and make our lives hell, and it's fun. It's the good kind of hell. So there you go. You can read all about competitive play below. I hope you guys enjoyed the unboxing of the Recruit Kit. And for those that are playing Overwatch, you can let me know how your experience has been in competitive play. What do I have to look forward to? Because I've not tried it yet. I'm going to tonight, probably. We'll see. I'm hopefully going to. But you can let me know what you've seen so far, how it's been for you so far, how people have been for you so far. Teammates, opponents, stuff like that. Because Quick Play has been, well, it's been an adventure. A bit of a mixed bag, obviously. Sometimes you get real fools and sometimes you get amazing teammates. an amazing opponent. But we're going to see. Again, read more below. Check back here soon for more. Both Overwatch and Tales of Lumen episodes. That's it. Give us one a like, share it, and do all the good stuff. Most importantly, though, happy recruit kit and Overwatch competitive play. Happy that.